Iran has been the leading sponsor of terrorism, and their pursuit of nuclear weapons threatens the civilized world. We will never let that happen.
That was the president this morning addressing the nation following two missile strikes on bases housing U.S. soldiers in Iraq. In that address, the president signaled a possible de-escalation of the conflict. I'm joined tonight by Colonel Ed Rao, who has over 50 years of national security and military experience, including with the Army, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and the Office of the Secretary of Defense. He now teaches a class on national security at Birmingham Southern. Sir, thank you for being here. Let's talk tonight about the threat that still exists. This has been a long week for military families, some 60,000 troops still in that region. Is there a threat that still exists in your view tonight in Iraq?
Well, a threat always exists when you've got a force in the field that is opposed to the United States being there. So you have, of course, Iran, and then you've got their network of militia in there that are opposing us. So the threat's always there, and it's going to be there forever.
We see the Iranian parliament essentially asking the U.S. to leave. We've heard the reignition of calls from some political figures saying maybe it's time to get out of Iraq. What say you with your years of experience?
I say it's not yet time, but it's something that should be considered. You've got to assess the situation, weigh the pros and cons, come up with the answer. Are we going to lose more by leaving and we're going to create a worse situation, or can we do something while we're there? What are objectives for staying there? You got to have clear objectives, and you got to have an end state, what you want it to look like when you leave. I don't think we've achieved that.
You don't think we've achieved that right
now?
Not
yet.
The vice president said tonight he believes the region, the world, is safer after what has happened. The president saying today they don't expect more escalation. Do you agree with that assessment?
Anytime you take an enemy force off the battlefield, it's going to be safer for your soldiers. So I would agree with that, yes. Does that eliminate all danger? No, it does not.
For military families, for those serving, wondering what comes next, we can speculate about threats all day. If there's a military family watching tonight, what would you say to them, especially ones who've not dealt with this kind of fear that they may be deployed at some point?
First of all, this is not unusual. It's been that way forever. Every time you get soldiers out in the field, there's a danger. They're always in harm's way. I would thank their families for letting them serve, and I would thank those soldiers for letting them serve our country. They're doing an important job, and they need to have a clear-cut mission and know what we want them to do and the desired end state for them to work toward.
Colonel Rao, we thank you for your service and thank you for your time and expertise tonight. Thank you for being here.
Well, thank you, Jack.
Sherry, Ashley, over to you.